Okay, Discord is open and I'm waiting to watch your stream.
Same.
You join the stream then.
No,
stream
I'm waiting.
All over my face.
We'll do that later, Scott.
Now that we've begun the show, I'm going to actually get prepared properly. Close my door. Oh god, and hit my mic. I'm so sorry.
Oh my god. I'm so sorry.
It's all falling apart.
Spooky music.
Well, it has to be. One and all to
oh,
the
you might want to turn it down, Michael.
Shut it's the fuck up. Loud. Doing the intro.
Or is that on my end?
Welcome to the Out of Focus Spooktacular. Ooh. Ooh. I'm Michael.
Out of focus.
I'm Scottula.
Oh, wait, no. I'm the Michael Man. There you go. It's like the Wolf Man.
I am. Nickenstein's Monster?
Nickenstein's Monster, I like that.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah, here we are with Halloweentown. This is different from our usual watch-alongs.
The critically acclaimed classic on the Disney Channel.
I mean, yeah. Or if critics just credit
it. Holy shit, that ghost is coming right at the screen.
this is different from
Did
our
usual...
Did
you guys see that?
From our usual fanfare, given the fact that none of us have actually watched this, whereas
no,
usually
no, I've seen it multiple times.
Okay,
childhood favorite.
You lied.
I never lied.
Earlier,
I never
said
I didn't
said,
see it.
Yes, you did earlier before we started recording.
Holy shit, those are clowns!
Oh shit, this movie's too scary. We can't do a commentary
already?
Over it.
There's ghosts and clowns
Hell
and play. Text. And shaky cam.
All burn bomb.
I'll give 20 bucks to anybody who watches this who can correctly guess the era in which this
90s.
Film was made. Yes. Well, not you.
Yo, what's up with this fucking close-up? Back up!
Yeah.
It's an intimate scene, Michael.
They're only children.
I never looked up Halloweentown on IMDb. Before we got this thing started, so I'm gonna do it now. 1998. Wow. Thank you all
for coming. You've been a lovely audience. How alive are you guys then?
Minus 1 year.
Okay.
Wait, no, 1 year. Sorry, I was
okay.
Alive.
Okay.
At least a year.
I'm guessing Michael was as well then.
Yeah.
I was born 1996,
which means you were alive
okay.
11 years. Math. Yeah, you guys haven't seen this movie before. What are your thoughts?
I think that the child looks like a young Rick Moranis.
Yeah.
Or as the kids call him, a young Rick Moranis.
Yes. Yeah. The youths do say that. Gotcha. And Scott, you've never heard of it, right?
No, never. I was never a Disney Channel kid.
Interesting, okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, I frequented this film because
I
was a Disney Channel kid. Yeah. I watched a ton of shows.
If you watch the opening of Disney Channel, there's Nick. He's 6 foot, and he looks as he does now, but he was 6 at the time, and he's happily jumping with the other kids.
Yeah, exactly.
So far to me, this just looks like a high budget Goosebumps episode, which
pretty much.
I watched all of those. Back in the 90s, but
so
I mean,
far,
yeah.
This looks like an equal budget Goosebumps episode. I'm gonna be honest.
Shots fired. So yeah, if you guys haven't been absorbing any of the plot thus far, her mom is refusing to let her go out trick or treating and participate in Halloween activities. Halloween is forbidden in this household.
Yeah.
If you leave this household for trick-or-treating, you shall be jailed!
Are they like Jehovah's Witness or something then?
No, we're going to find out later why Halloween is forbidden in this household.
But she wanted to do Halloween outside the household, so what the fuck is going on?
I'm sorry, was that a flying school? What is happening?
Yep, you betcha.
No, Debbie don't Reynolds. Have her just Mary Poppins. Don't have... She's Mary Poppins.
She's Mary Poppinsing.
I actually, growing up in South Africa, I never actually really did Halloween stuff. No.
So, have you embraced the culture now living in North America?
Mm-hmm. I'm 25. I don't go trick-or-treating.
So, yes.
Yes. The oldest I was when I went trick-or-treating was 18, and it felt really embarrassing and weird. And because we were older, houses had to sing for them if you wanted candy, which felt like, you know, ageist. But this wasn't supposed to be a personal story. I wanted to ask, what was your guys' scariest Halloween experiences? Beyond
this right here.
Movie. Yeah.
Sorry, our scariest Halloween or Halloween movie experience?
Either or, anything Halloween-based.
One of my trick-or-treating years, when I lived in Sherwood Park, I believe a group of my friends and I got chased by an older teen who was dressed as Michael Myers, or at least had a Michael Myers mask.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got chased around the neighborhood by him a couple times, and he was going around the neighborhood terrorizing kids. So that was pretty freaky.
Did he chase you in a run or a walk?
He ran. He wasn't authentic to the character.
Yeah, that wasn't the real. Scary. Because like it would have actually been scary if like you guys are running away, he was just walking, and you look back and he's gone, and you look ahead, he's ahead of you. Bam! It's the real Michael Myers.
Hello, how are you?
You're dead.
Yep.
Bam, you died, Nick. Yeah. Surprise.
I did die. And that's all, folks.
What about you, Scott?
I think the only story of note I really have, where I think it's just a little bit more psychologically scarring, maybe, was, what is it, in the prepubescent years, went trick-or-treating at one house, and it was, after we got the candy and stuff from the dude, it was then very evident that he had just been boinking his girlfriend. Because, yeah, you could see him, like, you could see he had just thrown on some boxers.
Okay.
And was still very much at half-mast, so.
There you go. Great. Scott tried really hard for a full minute to, like, not mention his rock-hard penis, and he tried to find the nicest way to do it.
That I'm trying to keep it PG anyone. With
and
our
then
movie
just
here,
like,
Michael.
Fuck it.
He, yeah, no.
You can see his dick.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yikes. I'm sorry to hear.
I had a similar experience with that, Scott, when I was shoveling, when I would go around neighborhood shoveling snow for some good old pocket
money. You would go
up
to the house, ask for candy, and they would just give you a dick instead?
Well, there was that. But also, like, there was one time I just finished shoveling a guy's driveway, and then, rang the doorbell because, hey, I need payment, and then he comes out in, a bathrobe, and then his girlfriend is peeking around the back corner, also in a bathrobe, and I was like, bro, were you fucking while I was shoveling your snow? What were you shoveling while I was shoveling?
He was plowing while you were shoveling.
Hey! Oh,
they got there in the end.
Yeah.
So yeah, Halloween Town.
Well, I don't think they did get them there in the end because you interrupted
right?
them.
Right? Like, yeah. You pain. Ruined their nice,
you
lovely romantic
that
evening.
Man.
Oh no, this is horrible.
That explains why he gave me $20 instead of $25.
because he
had you taken another 30 seconds to shovel. You know, of all the things I expected to talk about during the Halloween episode for Out of Focus commentaries, talking about various men's half-chubs and sexual encounters was not one of them.
Just two
so far, yeah. We'll see where the episode takes us.
Do you guys follow what's going
grandma
on?
Grandma came
still
to visit. Mom doesn't like her, and Grandma gave them all candy and Halloween costumes.
And Mom is still letting her be in the house.
Yeah.
Well, what do you fucking do? Get the fuck out, Grandma! Knock her to the ground. Beat
the shit
out of her. Go back
onto your magic school bus.
What are you doing in my house, you old bitch? Boom! and then throw her out. Is that what she should do, Scott? Because that'd be very funny. I was just going to ask, so we're about, let's see, 14 minutes into the movie. Has the plot developed beyond Harry Potter with ghouls? I mean, they're just like everyone else.
No, not really. Some of the slime is scrumptious. Yeah, I think they're, I think she's explaining what she believes is truth, but the kids aren't fully on board yet with, I think they're just thinking grandma's telling us a bedtime story, you know?
A vampire. I thought it said an umpire. The scariest monster of all. An umpire.
Yeah.
When I think of Halloween, I think of gnomes.
Ooh, a snotman.
Jill, what the fuck, Grandma? What the fuck? She looks like she's gaslighting her, like, yeah, you're gonna fall for this little trick.
Yeah.
It's me.
Yeah.
She doesn't look anything like you. She's way too cute.
Oh, that's dope. Ooh, I didn't know.
That's weird. That's a weird thing to say.
Just like Star Wars.
Just like Star Wars. When the battle droids kiss and are related.
The battle droids.
They are all related, though.
Roger, Roger, am I right? Speaking of Star Wars, Debbie Reynolds is Carrie Fisher's mom.
Oh, that's fun. Yeah, you can see the resemblance there.
We've got a demon!
In the background!
It's Bagul!
Hello, how are you?
You wouldn't want to miss your bus back home.
Yo! Yo, Scott, she's doing it! She's kicking her the fuck out! It's 11 p.m. It's like, get on your bus.
Yeah, get on your magic school bus.
Go back to your home, Grandma.
I'm going to put Dylan to bed, and then I will meet you down in the kitchen in 1 minute.
Of course, dear.
For a grudge match.
Yeah.
Mom versus the grudge, because it's Halloween.
No, there you just go.
Just fucking...
The grudge match.
Grab that longest hair, spin her around, because she's only the size of a child.
Get out of my house, demon! What is your guys' favorite Halloween movie? Or horror movie?
Favorite horror movie? Fuck.
What movie do you like to watch around the holidays? Well, since there's a bunch of dead air, I'll go first. Mine include the original Halloween from 1978.
Yeah.
And The Nightmare Before Christmas.
That's a good one.
Alternate those every year.
Yeah.
Oh, Trick or Treat.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Yeah, I'm just mostly trying to think of, like, the last one I really watched.
You don't really partake in doing Halloween festivities, hey?
No, not too much. Well, at least, like, movie-wise or, like, horror stuff as well. I guess I like the new It's.
Yeah, I really like the first one. I don't care for the second part as much.
Yeah, the first one was really, really well done.
Yeah. And it kind of works on its own, which is nice.
Yeah.
What are you doing here? I'm the man of the house. I gotta keep an eye on you.
He's the man of the house.
How can you be the man of the house when you're not in the house?
Kaboom! You've been lawyered.
There she is, but 10 feet away from us, which makes her blind to our presence because she's old.
It's funny because she is. Dude, that's just a toy.
No, it's fine.
That was so very much a toy bus.
If it's a toy bus, then how do they fit inside?
Oh, warp speed time!
They had a lot of goblin masks. Like, I understand Halloweentown has many different monsters, but they just have a lot of goblin masks.
So many of which would then be on be used in Lord of the Rings.
And also
a British Royal Palace Guard? What?
Yeah.
A Nutcracker.
That's where
actually.
They come from.
Yeah. They come from Halloweentown. I mean, Queen Elizabeth these days looks like straight something out of Halloweentown.
Maybe that's where they got her.
That's where they got her. Just picked a new one up at Halloweentown.
Yeah.
Can I return this? Sorry, sir, you bought this 80 years ago. No. Dang it, I was hoping for an exchange.
Yeah.
Oh, that big giant pumpkin in the middle of town always spooks me. Mm-hmm. Just turn around, go into Gregor's. Ah, fucking shit!
I never get used to it.
Some kind of friar goblin?
Ah, pumpkin people.
Aw, they're in love.
They must be so okay with the giant pumpkin head on display in the middle of town square.
Do you think that in Halloweentown ghosts can marry pumpkin heads? Because this looks like a very gentrified town to me.
I think so. Yeah. Oh god, what is that thing?
Our little sister. Get it out of here. Yeah.
It's like that one episode in The Office where they're at that bar and Angela sneaks up behind Dwight and he goes, fuck!
Also, Nick, you weren't very clear in terms of my question. I asked if you think that, like, the mixed race marriages can happen or the town is too gentrified, and you just said yes. I think so.
Michael, if anything has been established in this dynamic we have on this show, I think that answers your question perfectly. How do you think healthcare works in Halloweentown?
I remember now. I'm sorry. I will get to your healthcare. That's a good bit we can do.
The we'll
music
be right
in
back.
This fucking sucks. The music in this fucking sucks. And I want to shit on it.
It's a single man with a clarinet.
Halloween healthcare. Healthcare. Get it? But like H-A-L-L.
Yeah.
Healthcare.
Or alternatively, just do H-E double hockey six. Healthcare.
Healthcare.
I was going to say as well, like, you got health care for, like, the alive residents and unhealth care for, like, the dead residents.
How the hell do you wake up dead? Because you're alive when you go to sleep.
Right.
I'm feeling so energetic and strong today. What's wrong with me, doctor? Little skeleton.
Oh, that's good. That's good. I like that.
Also, how can he see the road?
How can't he see the road? You know, it's right in front of him.
Your taxi driver instincts.
I guess. Most taxi drivers aren't usually looking at the road anyways, so.
He also has GPS, so it's fine.
Well, let's just say that there are characters around here that ain't the most safe.
There are characters here in this story, and you gotta watch out for them.
Who is he? Catch me in the next life.
Thanks. Get it? Because she'll die one day and she'll be a skeleton.
Because death is coming for us all.
He's probably animatronic. Disneyland's full of stuff like that.
Ha! Was there ever a Halloween town in Disneyland? Is that what this is about?
No. It's an original idea.
Jeez, Scott, that was one fucking deep think. How deep in your mind palace did you go for that information?
Well, what would they have had before Haunted Mansion, right?
Unhaunted Mansion. Just Mansion.
Well, when did Haunted Mansion come into existence?
2000s, did it not? I guess. Is the movie based off of a ride?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, like a lot of those films, like Pirates of the Caribbean. And Jungle Cruise and stuff. It's all based on rides.
You just spilt a whole bunch of it.
No, it turned into fog. It's supposed to do it. Yeah. She knows what she's doing.
But, like, what is she making? Like,
she's putting in the microwave.
Which is brew, obviously.
You can't put cast iron in the microwave.
This movie is fake. No one ever uses those buttons on the microwave. Well, according to some random website I found, the attraction opened in 1969.
Nice.
No, Haunted Mansion.
Nice.
I've got it. The next Disney Channel original movie, Halloweentown. Maybe I just can't imagine creating an original property anymore.
No, it's physically impossible. I have to take a bathroom break, so you guys, the weight is on your shoulders for bits and clips.
Alrighty.
Enjoy your dump. Oh shit, Nick leaves, Scott dies, it's all on me.
It's Michael time.
I don't know, I'm too much on the spot. They're gonna have a shot of Ray Romano. He is the bad guy. There he is, Ray Romano.
Oh my god. Just because he's Italian doesn't mean he's Ray Romano.
No, you wanna dip the spoon into the actual liquid, not just the gas.
Yeah.
Everyone shut up, I've returned.
Powers are dumb.
Oh, it was quick.
Very.
It was too strong.
I summoned the will of God.
Oh, jeez.
Well, time for some more VFX.
That's not a spell. That's just Danish.
Oh, man.
Michael would know. He's from Africa.
Formula for hair replacement works like magic.
Hair replacement? What does it replace the hair with?
More hair.
Oh, no.
She's gonna check on the kids, and...
The people who started your Halloween just imitated our traditions.
Mortals cultural appropriation.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
That's the way your mother you're right.
This movie actually tackles really deep themes that are really relevant today.
Like healthcare. Oh, that was the worst costume yet. That was only paper mache. That was a paper mache head.
That is racist, Michael. That is a human being, Cyclops person.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, Nick. On your tangent, did you decide that Cyclopses are no longer valued as human beings?
Why would I deem them not worthy as human beings? You're the one making fun of their appearance.
They're paper mache.
Oh my god, he's just relentless, isn't he, Scott? We're gonna get demonetized.
Yeah.
Only now we are gonna get demonetized. Everything thus far has been A-OK for YouTube.
What are you looking at, smooth skin?
Yeah.
It's a used broom salesman.
Yeah. Ooh.
A microchip directional system whale.
They got fucking microchips in Halloween Town? The fuck is this? Well, I thought it was all magic and ghouls and shit. They got microchips up in here? They got Microsoft Paint in this place?
No, Michael. As the MCU has established, magic is just science we can't explain.
Yeah. That was a groan. I knew that.
We've killed Michael.
Your ancestors called it magic, and you call it science. Well, I come from a place where they're one and the same thing.
I'll catch you in another life.
Hey, don't sell me too short there, Grammy.
Don't sell me too short there, Grammy. I'm 5'2".
Maybe I can show you around sometime. Buy you an ice cream. The Abominable Snowman is a little shot there.
Twitching real nice.
You know, I was kind of hungry, but then I smelled something stinky.
Oh, shit. Fucking destroyed.
Boom!
Dude, look at his face. He's genuinely hurt.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
I'm friends with some very powerful creatures around here, you know.
This is the saddest day of his life. Somewhere in these arms, I'm on
your side. We'll fly it out.
Fucking hell, what is with these close-ups? Is headroom illegal in Halloween Town?
It's not called Headroom Town, Michael.
Everybody get back on the magic school bus. But since you won't
help her, magic school bus!
Just how I remember the intro.
Yep.
Marnie?
I've decided to kill you. Stabs with the broom. I'm a witch now.
How did the mom even get here?
Halloween Air.
Uber.
Yeah. Instead of a skeleton driver, it was just a low-paid employee who has actual workers' rights.
Oh, no. And what is the real horror, really?
The scariest thing of all, yeah.
Why is that little gremlin thing, like, hitting on the witch?
He wants to fuck her.
Oh.
You see, Nick? His goal is sex.
Now I understand.
Yeah.
And knowing is half the battle. G.I.
Joe! You used to like it. Or have you forgotten that part?
No.
Oh.
That's their dad. It's their dad. Oh my gosh, they finally get to meet dad.
So like, what? She had three kids with him and then just took off?
No, I'm being a gungus. Their dad was a human guy. He just
was very much dead now.
Yeah. Well, is he dead? Is he confirmed dead? Is he a ghoul?
Yeah, there was a graveyard scene that they cut from the movie.
Oh, okay.
The whole thing.
I'll get right to the point. I have a very urgent.
Yo, she's drunk. She's just drunk.
Yeah, this is just a drunk background.
Like they're playing this music to like make it look, oh, isn't it funny that she's like being weird? Like she's fucking hammered. It's 12
that just
PM.
Seems like a workplace hazard to hire her.
Yeah.
I'm not marrying anyone, and this discussion is over.
Okay, she's single forever. Never marry anyone. What?
Doesn't mean mom can't have fun.
I'm not gonna marry him, but I will need you kids to leave the room for 20 minutes.
That's why I'm here. He wants to reveal himself.
Whoa. Whoa.
Whoa. You're gonna want to get a restraining order for that.
Yeah.
I don't fear him or any creature.
What about snakes?
Why did it have to be snakes?
Yeah.
What about poisonous spiders? What about a shark?
What about mummies?
No, the mummy's great. Mummy's great. He's just misunderstood. He just wants to enslave humanity, damn it.
Well, which one am I talking about? I'm talking about the Brendan Fraser one or the Tom Cruise one?
Yeah, the good one.
Oh, fuck her. If there is a mummy...
You know, we had to wait all these years for them to finally perfect the mummy movie.
Yeah.
You're making me clench my sphincter here, Nick.
Tom Cruise really can do it all.
If you want to give up your roots, that's fine. But I don't. And it's not right for you to try to make me.
Got her.
I have decided it is eat shit and die.
Something going on with the wiener, dude.
Yo, hey, the mummies!
We mentioned something, and then it showed up on screen.
Maybe we're the witches.
I think we are, now that you mention it.
He just has a key for it? I thought he was a hooligan, but apparently he owns property?
He's not a hooligan, Scott. Did you see his sweater? They were sitting there and they watched the Morbius 2022. This is what happens. Have sex. Oh shit, he's morbing.
This is where the fun begins.
Oh,
what is?
Oh my.
Oh, is that shit, Apocalypse? Oscar Isaac? It's Ray Romano.
Oh god. This is a really scary part of the movie. Nothing but exposition.
What if she pulled out a gun? It's like, nothing you can stop me. Bam, she's dead.
Give me the talisman.
Never.
Never. Not gonna do it.
Whoa, sweet dodge. Holy crap!
Bye.
That dude is gone.
Oh, don't touch that railing. That's how you get tetanus. It's
probably needles on there.
Probably also hot as shit. It's summer in Halloweentown. Why is it summer in Halloweentown if Halloween is in October?
Well, in the States, Michael. He's gonna turn us into
statues and gonna follow us. October is in fall! In the States!
Can still be hot.
No, it's only summer in the States, Michael.
Oh my goodness.
And Halloween Town is one of the 50 states.
Well, if you think about it...
No, Halloween I don't want to think about it, Scott.
This great population of, I don't know, a multitude of things. And when kind of a lot of things gather together, it's almost like a jungle-like environment.
That's exactly how I would describe it. I think that's actually how science describes it, too.
Yeah, so Halloween Town is kind of like a jungle unto itself. So when are we going to see Tarzan, then?
You're really trying to put that square piece into the round hole. You're forcing it as hard as it will go.
It's gonna go through, Michael.
Just gonna get me a hammer. And I'm gonna put this fucking square in this circle. Oh, wow.
He's looking a little pale in the face there.
How could they do that? How could they make that poor man wear a mask and play basketball? He's gonna fucking melt. It's Tim from Tim and Eric. Is that the snot man? There he is.
Yeah.
He's off to star in his own Marvel Cinematic movie.
No death guard on duty. Did you guys see that?
I did.
No. It's a good joke.
Yep.
I was making an MCU joke, so I can focus on the movie jokes. I'm going to say we're going to get snot man.
Does that mean, Nick, that if you slip and fall, you have a chance of being alive then?
No, it wouldn't. Because you can go to bed and not be dead, and you can die but not be in a bed.
But you are in a bed, man. That's how you wake up dead in the first place, fool.
A real ghost and a real sweatbox.
Sure. Make fun of the transparent guy.
Make fun of the guy who fucking died in real life. I was alive. Fucking dead.
Woo! Is it getting hot in here? Hades was nothing compared to this.
Oh, so he was in hell. I don't feel sorry for him anymore.
Oh, that pumpkin child has a toothache.
Yo, what the fuck?
So there is a dental plan in this universe.
No, it's not a dental plan. I think it's just... There's no... Why is there no, like, Novocaine or something? It's gonna have to
come out. Oh my god, look at this.
Don't hurt me, doctor. I'm not very good with pain.
Ooh. Now, don't worry. He won't feel a thing.
Yeah, this is why I don't like the close-ups. This is why the movie's actually scary.
Oh... Okay.
Wow. Imagine this movie with 3D glasses.
No.
I'd rather
don't imagine it. Imagine it right now.
It would just be prosthetic noses in our faces the entire time.
I got it. Gets hit by a car.
I fell off that. That's what was gonna happen.
Just a random dog in Halloweentown.
Yo, that dog's just gonna run the street now. That's not okay.
That's a loose dog now. How do we know that's a dog and not a werewolf?
It had a leash on.
You don't know what he's into.
I thought you said you're a witch. I mean, the least you can do is remember a dumb spell.
Okay.
You're right. I am a piece of shit. I'll remember the spell now that you've fucking shat
me out. Thank you for the pep talk.
What is it, Soph?
Your sister just goes into a fucking demonic trance.
It's like Bekikia. So, like, is that guy who went to the Shadow Realm gonna come back, or is he's gone now?
Okay. We'll have to find out. Boob check. Still got boobs.
How can they be frozen in time if their hearts are still going?
Mm-hmm. Also, why didn't they check their pulses, Nick?
Yeah, Nick.
They don't need to.
They can just tell?
Yeah.
Grandma said something about installing it.
Oh, fuck. They gotta update the Mac OS.
Yeah. They gotta update the drivers.
Check driver, right click, check driver, check for updates. Must be connected to internet, but I can't connect to the internet because my fucking driver's out of date.
Do you remember what Grandma said? Well, when it's dark on Halloween, where do you put the candle? Come on.
Up my ass.
Michael.
It lights Whoa! Away.
It's up Scott's ass, not yours.
Evil within us to reveal ourselves as we are.
Please do not reveal yourself. Oh, please stop revealing yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, phew.
Dad?
Papa? The quiet got real. The crowd got really quiet when they found out it was just the mayor. Like,
yeah.
They were on board. It was like, oh, shit, we got, like, Emperor Palpatine with us here. He's got, like, a sack bag. He's a pretty cool monster. It's like, it's me, the generic mayor. Everyone's like, oh, okay. Oh, wow, she did it. Okay, back to bed.
Yeah. And does she, like, vaporize him then?
She gets vaporized. She was too close. She dies. Oh, are we gonna spin it back out?
Whoa, I'm undead again.
For a second there, I thought I was alive.
Yeah.
Phew.
Got all the power of the Cromwells and twice the guts.
I am all the Cromwells.
You could have had me. The most powerful warlock of all.
Was there like a national survey to see who was the most powerful warlock of all, or has he just been saying it?
Well, I mean, look at like the town population size, right? Like there's like 150 people or something.
I still say needs a survey.
Yeah.
Hey, chocolate bar! You better get that.
Oh! Fucking roasted!
Why did she call him fucking chocolate bar?
Chocolate bar is a slur in Halloweentown.
Yeah, it's a slang here. The power of family!
Hit it, guys. Literally hit
it. It's morphin' time!
Literally hit him with a brick. Throw a brick at him.
Right? Go, go. Magic brick.
Come on, Dylan. We need you. Believe.
Come on. Do it.
Do it now. Kill him, Dylan.
Mama!
Shoot him, Dylan. Hit him with the brick, Dylan.
Dylan! Son of a bitch.
No, no, you have...
Whoa!
You will become an Adobe After Effect.
Yeah, they just vaporized him.
More like vaporize.
Yeah.
From Envy, movie with Jack Black and,
What?
Ben Stiller.
No. No.
And I'm sorry about the things I said. And did.
And I'm sorry that I didn't trust
you. Sorry, I committed all those war crimes.
Yeah, that is the world's vaguest fucking apology. I'm sorry about all the things I said and did. What
hey, it covers all your bases, man. It works in every occasion.
An apology card for all occasions. I'm sorry about all the things I said and did.
There you go.
Yeah. Now suck it.
Hi. Wow.
You are fucking hideous.
You know, Mother, I have to admit, you're really very good with them.
Keep them.
I don't want them anymore.
Now, in our mortal realm, are they still able to do magic? Oh, yeah, I guess, because you did the whole chicken thing earlier, so.
And made a cookie float.
Yeah. Oh, so it's only food-based stuff. You know who she would work really well with, then. Food boy, of course.
Yeah.
I don't think he needs any help. I think he's got it figured out.
No, he needs help. He needs help.
He needs
just
tons
not,
of...
just not the kind you're thinking of.
Yeah. Right.
Oh, you were right, Nick. He has been forced to become the bus driver.
Yeah.
Yep. You must ferry souls from one plane to the next.
Yes. That is your eternal charge.
He lives on the bus now. He can't leave it.
Yeah.
Yep. Oh yeah.
He's soulbound.
Part of the bus. Part of the crew.
The goblin from earlier in the movie theater, he was not spat back out. He is definitively dead.
Oh, yeah. Nope. Bye, everybody. Especially those cyclops.
How does that look like simultaneously the world's most and least expensive costuming shot?
Well,
and it's over. Oh.
The first of four movies.
Yeah. The Halloweentown verse.
Yep. Yeah. What did you guys think of it? What did you think?
No.
Nick?
What did you think of it?
It's kind of dog shit.
It's very much a Disney Channel original film.
Direct to VHS.
Yep.
I personally thought it was going to be a lot more like Paranorman, you know, with like an overall plot and story and characters and just like a cool Halloween vibe. Well, I guess that would answer my question from far earlier. Paranorman would be my favorite Halloween movie because it's just It has the spirit of it all. This felt like if somebody with a bunch of Halloween costumes and friends made a movie.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, so low budget film. It very much just works for kids as an entertainment source.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it kind of knows its market. And oddly enough, it isn't really, you know, grown men in their 20s and 30s.
Yeah, go figure. I do look fondly back on it just because I have that nostalgia of watching it a couple times when I was younger.
Yeah. I think I would probably be the same with Goosebumps if I were to like rewatch a whole bunch of that stuff.
Right.
Or Are You Afraid of the Dark? Like I'd very much know what getting into, so
yeah.
It's
a lot less like fantastical. It's very much just like Halloween Town and Halloween themed in name, but then it's very much just like the real world. Where there's like barbershops and used car salesmen and taxi drivers and stuff. It's not as disconnected from our world.
No.
It's just Halloween variations, right? It looks like a spirit Halloween took over a community.
Not even took over. Put out some hay bales, put out one big pumpkin and a fog machine here and there. Does anything fun happen in the sequels?
So the second one, Return to Halloween Town, Calabar's Revenge. You could probably guess what happens in that.
Calabar comes back
for revenge. The third one, I think, is Halloween Town High, where a group of Halloween Town residents come to the mortal world. And have to go into.
High school.
They go into witness protection, basically, and become high school students.
Okay.
And then the last one, I don't actually remember what that one's even called, but something Halloween Town.
Return to Halloween Town.
So Halloween, the second one is just Halloween Town 2, Calabar's Revenge, and then the last one is Return to Halloween Town.
Oh my god.
And Return to Halloween Town has Lucas Grabeel.
What are you doing? What?
Yeah.
What do they even learn there?
What don't they learn?
Oh my god.
There he is. Our Lucas.
Mm-hmm. Our Lucas.
Okay, I'm just noticing some things here. Why is this person photoshopped in? Okay, so it's one person's body, torso, another person's pants.
But like that arm.
Yeah, another person's
That
pant.
That's not coming out of the shirt how it should be.
Like look at how thick his fucking neck is according to this.
Oh yeah.
8 reasons why New from Halloween Town should have ended up with Luke, the smoking hot goblin.
Why is that a BuzzFeed article?
And why are there 8 whole reasons behind it?
Give me the reasons.
You're going to have to click multiple times.
Number one, he's hot.
Plus the way money sasses him back. But that's not reason 3.
They probably had like a childhood crush.
See, this is not reason 3. Reason 2 is a two-parter. Because they couldn't fit the whole gif in one. So his feelings for Marnie made him realize that he was on the wrong... That's fucking bullshit. No, it's not. He fucking realized he was on the wrong side of the fight because Emperor Palpatine froze Grandma. She's a badass witch who knows how to take charge, and he's ready to hop on the back of her broomstick and ride off into the sunset. Jeez.
Is that like an allegory for pegging or something?
You know,
Jesus Christ.
And 8, Luke, aka Philip Van Dyke, has aged like fine wine. Can we see Philip Van Dyke?
I mean, you can't compare him to like the actual actor now. You got to keep it in universe.
Yeah, let's see Philip Van Dyke in modern day goblin makeup. You know, let's see Philip Van Dyke wearing this. Is he still hot? Yeah, I regretted that.
As you should with any BuzzFeed article.
Halloween Town is the movie that just keeps on taking.
Yep, indeed.
Taking us back to the box office for more.
things happened there. It was just like very simple, like surface level things. Like
very.
Find out about Halloween Town. There's an evil lurking in the background. Their mom and grandma get paralyzed. Then they have to go complete the witch's brew.
Yeah.
And then they have to defeat Calabar.
Yeah.
I don't do it again, okay?
All while ensuing hijinks throughout the residents of Halloween Town.
Oh, bless you, Scott.
Thank
that
you.
That was Nick.
Bless you, Scott.
Cool.
All right. Well, I think we've extracted as much possible content as there is.
We have thoroughly beat this horse dead.
We have pulled it down. Into the ground. We pushed it down harder than Mom pushed down Grandma.
Exactly.
Get on the fucking bus, Halloween Town. Get out of here.
Yeah. Thank you so much for tuning in to this spooky themed Halloween commentary episode of Out of Focus.
Yes.
Make sure to be good ghouls and boys and girls.
And be sure that when you're ringing someone's doorbell, they don't have a half chub. Happy Halloween!
Oh, no. Bye-bye.
Bye. Laboratory in the castle east, to the master bedroom where the vampires feast. The ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode. They did the mash. They did the monster mash. The monster mash. It was a graveyard smash. They did the mash. It caught on in a flash. They did the mash. They did the monster mash.